Hey guys, Professor Bill, Comic Book University in the Flash, issue number 54. I debated not getting this book, but I decided let me just see how the conclusion goes with this storyline. Let's say I'm happy that I did finish this up. This was a good one, and I've mentioned before, conclusion of a story is three times or more important than the introduction to a story. It's one thing to get you, it's another thing to feel like you've been got. All right, let's get to who actually wrote this book, who did the book. So this is Grips of Strength, the conclusion. Joshua Williamson is the writer. Christian Deuce is the artist. Luis Guerrero is the colorist. Steve Wands is the letterer. Dan Mora did the cover. Howard Porter and Arif Prianto did the variant cover. You know, it's funny. I actually got the opportunity to, well, I had the opportunity to meet Joshua Williamson at Fan Expo Canada on that Thursday. And he actually had a really long line. And I just, yeah, there were just too many other places to go and too many other things to do. So I didn't even bother. And again, that was on a Thursday. That was a premium day. So kudos to Joshua Williamson, man. I kind of wish I would have had the juice to just stay in the freaking line. I didn't even want to enter the line. Like, it was just way too, forget about it, man. It wasn't quite as big as like Tom King and all those other guys, but it was a pretty big line. So I was impressed. Good for him, man. Seriously, good for him. This story ends up by having the Flash figure out the strength force. Is it a complete understanding? Heck no. But he does learn it and understand it, and he's able to morph it to his own desires pretty quickly. He would have died if he didn't figure it out. So, you know, necessity is the mother of all inventions. Every engineer knows that. So this was pretty interesting the way that he figured it out. And they did the setup really nice. You know, here, I've been a big critic of how dumb Barry Allen seems in this particular run. He can't figure out anything about the Speed Force. And you'd think that right away I would, you know, not attack. I'm not an attacker type, but that I'd, you know, just puke all over the idea of, hey man, he can't figure out the freaking Speed Force, but he figures out the Strength Force. Wow, that's convenient. But the comic was pretty self-aware. And in the narrator's boxes, it pointed out how the Flash had figured out all sorts of other problems by his understanding of the Speed Force. Therefore, or vis-a-vis, he should be able to figure this out. Again, he was going to die. Trickster was going to die. This is an immediate situation. And something that I guess I haven't noticed, and it may seem as though I've been unfair with the comic book, and I definitely don't want to be unfair with the comic book, but looking back by reading this comic book, I realized that it's not that Flash is stupid. It's that he's impulsive. And that makes sense considering his main power. Moving fast, doing things really fast. All the ladies love him exactly for that. But that's like the oldest Flash joke. But rather, he's just impulsive. Everything about him is get it done now. What's in front of me? Tackle that first. Oh, there's another problem I should deal with. I'll get to it later. I'll get to it when it's on the fringe. And I really noticed that because of his relationship with Iris at the end. It's like, dude, it was killing you. All right, it was proverbially killing you that you weren't with Iris and she didn't want to be with you anymore. She didn't even want to talk to you anymore, dude. She was so mad at you that even her friends and relatives were telling you back off, dude, because you suck. That's when he was like, I gotta work on my relationship. But now that he's back with her, he even mentions like, okay, now that we're back together again, blah, 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 whatever. And then she goes and gives him a hard question. She goes and says, what is Commander Cold, what's Commander Cold's name? You didn't get to meet this person. You didn't get to know this person yet. You know nothing about him. You only know the surface stuff. So, okay, I'll deal with that stuff later. There he goes again. I'll deal with that stuff later. Okay, Barry, I want to talk. You don't want to talk? Fine. Don't talk for your sake. But I want to talk. Talk for my sake. That's always a big thing in a relationship. Somebody just wants to walk away. I can't deal with this right now. Okay. What you are saying is you don't want to deal with this right now. What you're saying is, you know, you're not worth my time right now. I would rather spend some me time instead of actually working this out. I don't want to deal with this. Oh, you can't handle not talking right now? Too bad on you. You really want to talk? F you. That's exactly what you're saying. Make no mistake. There's no wheedling out of this. This is exactly what is being said. Go ask a shrink. So the other person could potentially try and just, you know, deal with it. And Iris was willing to deal with it. Obviously, she's willing to deal with it. But for how long? At what point is she finally going to say, you're always putting yourself first? You don't care about me. If you cared about me, then one time you would stop and say, okay, I don't really want to talk about this, but clearly you do, so go ahead. You know what I'm saying? Like, when has he done that? You know, he didn't do it this issue, that's for sure. And I barely, it's like he just got back together with her. Just. And already he's just dumping all over. I can't deal with this right now. Okay, but I want to talk. But he doesn't care. Wow, man. But when all of a sudden she's like, okay, you know what? I'm leaving again. And this time it's permanent. No, wait, let's talk. I don't really want to talk right now. But I do. Yeah, Barry, you are a jackass. You are a jackass. And I'm loving the way he's being written right now. Okay, and literally, this is me kind of, I'm kind of folding back in. I'm caught back in the fold because I caught a different vibe with this comic book. It's funny. By Joshua Williamson explaining in advance that he's able to figure out this, this, and this, and that's why people lived. I don't know if he intended for it to be conveyed that Barry Allen only deals with the problems that are right in front of his face. You know, say he's not willing to handle the piano, like going back to the old Acme Inc. Looney Tunes. This is Warner Brothers, so the old Looney Tunes cartoons. He's not concerned with the anvil or the safe that's being, you know, held aloft over top of his head. He doesn't care about that, all right? But when the rope snaps, that's when he cares. That's when all of a sudden he's going to be like, oh, crap, I need to drop everything and take care of this right now. You're literally holding everything to the last minute. And by the last minute, that's not true. That's not entirely true. It's the 11th hour. You're already on the cross, all right? I hate to pull some religion into this, but, like, you're already up on the cross. You're nailed there. Here's the cup, you know, held right in front of you to drink from. It's done. There is no, okay, now I think I should deal with the whole they don't believe in me thing. Not what the hell, dude? What the hell? Before was it, now you have to deal with something else entirely. Now you have to deal with the idea that you got some nails through your hands. You know, again, hate to bring the religious aspect of this, but, like, that's exactly what Barry Allen seems to be. He waits until he's about to die, or someone he loves is about to die, or his relationship is about to, he literally waits until it's too late, and now he wants to deal with it. But they've been dealing with it this whole time, and nobody cares that you've been dealing with all these other things. That's called organizational skills, and nobody who served in the military will ever cut you a break on your lack of organizational skills. It's just never gonna happen. Good luck with that, son. This was great. Because I've been seeing Barry Allen screw up over and over again, and now I can finally place where and why he's screwing up. If he would have just, like I've said so many times before, if he would have just stopped and said, okay, listen, you know what? Maybe something is going to happen bad to the city. That's terrible. But I need to figure out my Speed Force and how this thing actually works, or else. And now the future is gone. He can't go back into the future at this point. Back to the future. Go back in time. No, he can't go back to the future right now and try and figure out how he effed everything up. He can't. It's gone. It's, once again, it's too late. Oh, here's a guy from the future. He's right in your face. And you don't even bother to ask this dude his name. He's not even a human being to you at this point, bud. Yo, I dig the psychology of this. And again, maybe Joshua Williamson wasn't intending for this to be the case, but everything just seems to be working way too perfectly for him to not have meant for this to be how we're supposed to interpret Barry. I dig that. Again, I'm going to love the psychology of a comic book way more than I'm going to love any fist fight, you know what I'm saying, or any laser beam action in space or whatever. I don't care about that stuff. That's like, okay, cool. Hey, really good art. Awesome, awesome, awesome. I don't care about the writer at that point. That's where I'm looking at the artist. But when it's not action, that's 100% on the writer. There's, I don't know, 90% on the writer. The artist can also do facial expressions that will convey that. And, you know, I'm not really getting that necessarily, but it's hard to argue with this art. The end of this comic book, for the sake of conversation, was pretty cool. Because Trickster meets the original Trickster. Now I'm interested. Now I'm interested because, again, I haven't been on the Flash comic books in a while, so with all due respect, I didn't realize there was a second Trickster. I had no idea there was a second Trickster. I just thought this was the way that he was written now at this point. That's funny. That's funny. Okay, so cool. Looks like I got some homework to do. All right, I'm on it. Definitely enjoyed this comic book. This was really good. This was really good. Anyway, guys, this is going to be it for me. New storyline starting, in 2 weeks. I don't know if I'm ready to go back to the physical copies yet. Maybe. We'll see. Anyway, guys, okay, now it's it for me. Professor Bell, Comic Book University. Class dismissed.